Love all. Reverse pendulum. We don't see that too often in the women's game. A little homage to Matilda Ekholm.
Love two.
So Natalia Bayor takes the first 2 points on serve. Bernie Such's serve now. Quality third ball to spin from a step behind the table. Again, Bernie Such can generate a whole lot of spin. Bit of an unusual shot here. Bernie Such seems surprised herself, but still adapted to the ball coming in. So far, server percentage right now, 100% on each side. Now, both of these players have this shot, the flat hit when they need it. It's a bit risky. But if you calibrate and you calculate just right to the spin coming in, that flatter shot can be very tough to rally with.
4-2.
The first 2 points this match that have been scored against the server from the receiving position. Bernie Such at the first towel break with a 2-point lead here. Again, that reverse pendulum serve, very difficult not only to serve, but to read.
5-2.
Looking smooth here, close to the table, Bernie Such. I mentioned in the women's game, it's a battle of speed typically. Women tend to stay closer to the table. On average, not as big of footsteps as the men.
2-7.
So as you get behind the table, there's just more ground to cover. It takes a lot more steps to do that. 7-3. Beautifully effective shot here. The racket speed from Bayor snaps the wrist for a whole lot of spin in that short stroke shot. 4 points between them once again. Smart placement, good foresight here. Natalia knows that this ball is going to be uncomfortable. Baits Bernie into stepping around, leaning into that backhand corner. 5-7. That's the change of pace I was talking about before the match. Smart play, very brainy from Bayor. Sees Bernie a step behind, plays it very softly. Bit of side spin on it, shallow indeed. 5-8. A much needed point for Bernie Such. Hanging in with the change of rhythm, constantly mixing it up. Bayor on the other side. A few flatter shots, then going for the spin from the wide backhand.
8-6.
Power opening up, Bernie Such.
9-6.
Third ball attack, serve and attack. This is the setup that many want. Topspin comes in, early timing here, taking it off the bounce.
6-10.
So game point 4 times over. I think Bernie Such adjusting to a few of the calls here in terms of how things are said. Well, adjust she does, and she takes game number one. Bernie Such, 1-0. Tomahawk serve, one of her signatures. Very unusual shot, that forehand, a bit of a pancake flip with the forehand side. The attack, but little rotation on the ball. Perfect placement here for Natalia Bayor. Heavy spin comes in, closed racket, using the backhand from out on the forehand side.
Let one off.
Oh.
1-2.
Bayor doesn't make it easy. Bernie Such with the big shot that feels like a finisher, and it comes right back to the elbow. Front now. Again, her variation in the touch, a bit of side spin with the underspin on it.
3-all.
Interestingly enough, every receive that I can recall from Bayor has been passive, meaning she's played underspin on the receive. You will see from time to time a player trying to get aggressive in the receive game.
4-3.
Especially with the long serve coming in, you don't need as big of a stroke, but long and fast like that gives the opening attack to Bernie Such, but it was surprising. Bayor takes the point.
Four ball.
Okay, now we've got ourselves a battle here. The exchange behind the table, Bernie finding her way back in, a bit of multitasking. Oh, the angle on this one. Oh, Bayor cannot do much mayor. Cannot do mejor. Either way. Polish players rarely speaking Spanish. From time to time, it'll happen. Two punches in a row. Recovers from the net. Bayor up by two. Scoreboard. Last time they played, Bernie Such won the first game. Bayor took the next two.
6-5.
And by two, I would like to extend that and say three. Three in a row after losing the first, Bayor, last time they played. It was Bernie Such who won the last three to win the match. Clever placement, that elbow. Again, if you're newer to table tennis, you might think that they're aiming for the corners of the table. But at this level, speed is so high that they're actually trying to find a place where someone gets a little bit off balance, hesitates for a moment. They're trying to hit the elbow, the crossover point first, and then create an opening. Usually takes multiple shots to win a point at this level. But here it's one and done on the receive. Bayor quick to the wide forehand, the opening backhand attack.
Seven all.
Wider into the forehand side this time around. Bernie saying, yeah, go ahead and use your backhand if you want, but it's going to be even less comfortable, and I'm going to shut down your swing. Shovel serve, bravo indeed. Bayor up by one once again. Quality push, block. That's all it takes there. Service game strong and a 2-point lead for Bayor. Remember, last time they played, if it was a best of five, in theory everything would have been different, but Bayor was leading 3-1 in that best of seven battle.
8-9.
Much like the first serve of the match, Bernie Such getting the ball popped up. Rather, first serve of this game. Tomahawk serve.
8-9.
She's very subtle in the way she contacts the ball and how she changes up the rotation, Bernie.
9-0.
Tied up at 9 points apiece. Now, if you've heard Bernie interview before after winning a match, she snuck in, and by snuck, I mean earned her way up into the top 10 in the world for the first time not too long ago. And she said, well, under coach Viorel Filimon there, number 5 is on the list for me. I want to be top 5 in the world. That's my next goal. She scooted up to 8 in the world. Right now sitting at 9, but a lot of points up for grabs here. This pressure to the deep backhand corner. That's 3 in a row for Bernie Such, and she sets up a game point for a 2-0 lead. deep to that corner. Bernie Sutz sneaks it out after a long serve to the backhand. Says, okay. Back for game number three, Natalia Bayor to serve. Bernie with that backhand down the line. Surprise factor. You watch that from up here and you think to yourself, and when I say up here, I mean the camera angle that I'm watching with you. It feels like that's a cross-court shot. Good surprise.
Too low.
Variation in the push game sneaks it past Bernie Sutch. On the board here in the third. Natalia Bayor looking to get in. Now she's on.
One, three.
The timeout
time
here.
Out.
Back from the conversation with Coach Necek.
One, four. Five, one.
Ever since the timeout, still more the same way. Bernie Sutch not dropping a point.
Five, two.
And the first one since the timeout here for Bayor. Long way to go here in this third game.
2-6.
Again, sometimes you have a lot to decide really quickly in table tennis. Shows push, goes for the flick, backed up a little bit.
2-7.
Positioning and rhythm are such major parts of the game. In a game that's so fast in any given moment, keeping yourself on balance, ready to recover. It's one of the great challenges of the game. But serves strong once again for Bayor. Gets her third point on the scoreboard. 4 points between them and 4 points between Bernie Sutch and the finish line. Good pressure on the short side. Bayor on top of the bounce. Keeping that hand cool. One wide and then from the middle, it's the backhand. The change of direction with the short stroke. Flat kill shot, Bernie. Second towel break. Makes me want to start looking at the draw. Remember, we have had qualifying rounds all the way through. Meaning several players have to play through the qualifications to get here.
4-9.
Down the line, Bayor.
9-5.
What's it going to take at this point? She'd really have to rattle Bernie Sutch, but it's going to be 1 point at a time to get under the skin.
9-6.
Shortest one yet. Getting slower and slower in the block. Watch this, racket high. That last one very shallow. Really tough to time. Bernie Sutch wasn't able to move the feet back into the table. And the pancake flip well received on the other side. Nice breakfast served up there. Racket high. Open face at first and then behind the ball. Bayor within two. Unbelievable, the timeout called here after a long string of points here, Bayor. 8-9 after 4 on the trot for Natalia Bayor. It's a cracking forehand and she continues. It is not over yet. If she can keep the pedal to the metal, keep the brain cool in these moments. The decisions here, short stroke, a little bit across the ball to go to the corner. It's Bernie Such with two big serves to come. No, from behind the table. The fadeaway forehand falling back, and still Bayor continues. Six in a row, and now a game point for Poland's Natalia Bayor. Ooh, the flick took the chances on the receive. And it was quite an impressive one. Makes the opening attack. The first point in a long time for Bernie Such. Deuce. Alternating serves here in game three. No timeouts left for either player. The change of pace, and it is another game point for Natalia Bayor. Bayor takes it from down 4-9. It looked like it was over. Players back for game number four. Bernie Such leading 2-1. Remember, momentum on her opponent's side. Bayor continues. First point, and it's on receive. Since game number two, that tomahawk serve has been a favorite, a go-to for Bernie Such. Surprised that she stuck with it so much. It is one of her most iconic serves, no doubt about it. Long serve with that backhand. In the deep end of last game, the last time we saw that serve, to memory, it was a bit shorter inside the table, that spin. Unbelievable. One deep to the baseline, one more shallow with the backhand. And then watch what happens. Soft there, shallow, forehand slap, and not even touched on the other side. Just the same here from Bernie, though, gets the free hand up in the air to get on the scoreboard for her second point once again. So with the first towel break here, Bayor, you can feel the shift in confidence. You can see the hope in the eyes there after that show. Bayor, there's a sense of belief.
Four, three.
And of course, both players coming to the table must have belief. This is the life of a pro athlete. Rallies, the flat forehand finish. Bayor, after this long exchange, finds an opportunity. That's the one. Short stroke, racket high. There's the fire. Looking back at her coach. Covering that elbow here as well. Bayor in control of the scoreboard now. She came back from 4-9 in the game before this. Look at her redirecting traffic out here. This could be the intersection of the scoreline. Bernie can't do much to bother Bayor right now. The quality of shots Bernie's bringing. Many players have felt this way against Margarita Pezotska, Gina Poda, Natalia Bayor just the same, getting everything back. Good power on the parallel here from Bernie Such, finding the edge of the opponent's racket. Second serve here for Bayor. Interesting. Remember, they have no timeouts left. Bernie finding a place that's just a little bit questioning there, testing the forehand side of the elbow from Bayor. You could see a moment of hesitation there from Bayor. Guarded optimism from Viorel Filimon. That variation again, two flatter backhands and then the spin shot. Natalia Bayor looking to take this to the decider, which is just one stop on the way to the final destination in this match, if Bayor's going to take it. Bayor's finding freedom right now. That confidence, the quickness to decide. She's on autopilot. There's nothing getting under her skin at the moment. Not even the net ball on the way over. Long serve. And it is 5 game points for Poland's Natalia Bayor. Beautiful backhand from Bernie. One game point saved here. Serves back with Bernie. Back to the tomahawk serve. Well played, shorter. 2 game point saved. Bernie holding in those screams and shouts. Should she get to 10-10, I imagine we would hear one. Cracking forehand does it, 11-7. The most dominant game. 56% winning percentage in the decider, 3% higher than Bernie Such. You might think 3% out of 100, well, these pros, they've played their fair share of battles that come down to the wire. And momentum right off the block, out the gates here. Bayor quick to convert. That for me was big. And if Bernie had a timeout, she'd take one now. It's interesting, percentage in the decider. Bernie, one of the most confident people I've ever met. This combination is so good from Bayor. Two parallels in this rally, back to back, and still Bernie in position. Bayor with the furrowed brow, both actually in that moment. Can feel the nerves in the arena.
Three, two.
And the roar is coming back. You have to wonder if that was part of the conversation. Rarely do you see players cheering the way Bernie just had when they're trailing. As wide as can be, this is going to be a furious fight to the finish. Mentally, any competitor can tell you, when you hear your opponents scream and shout, there's this desire to out-scream and shout them in some weird way. Especially if you think that it might have any sort of implications to their confidence, any effect.
3-4.
I think the winner will be quite vocal from here on out in this final game of the match. Back and forth they go. They will switch sides of the table here as it is the final game in the 5th game of any best of five, the decider in any match. Players will switch sides of the table. Serves now with Natalia Bayor, who started strong here with the first 2 points on serve. Flat hit, cracking forehand. The 3-point lead, a little deja vu from last game. In game number 3, 4-9 down. Natalia Bayor didn't like the score line. She didn't complain, she took some action.
3-7.
As deep as can be on the table. I was wondering if it caught the edge. We saw the hand there for a minute. Bernie sort of pointing at the back of the table. Remember, with this much prize money and this many points up for grabs, it's a lot to play for. Clever idea. Corner to corner, Bayor opened the table. Missing by a narrow margin. Ernie Such trying to get back that confidence. Ooh, break off the top of the net and at the second towel break. Bayor looking at a potentially big upset. We've got one other smash already on schedule this year, the China smash. But it won't be for a while. Coming into the Olympic Games, this is the last smash before then.
9-4.
Service strong, Bayor. Her percentages, that 3% differential in how they perform in the decider is about to change by even more. Six game and match points. Natalia Bayor was down 0-2 and 4-9.
Let fall 10.
Beautiful follow-up, earning herself the third ball. Bernie Such saves one match point. Catching the edge of the racket. Bit of kick on this second bounce. A variation in the spin game on serve, four match points left. Natalia Bayor has been very effective with her serves. Ooh, nerves. You can feel them. Bernie Such has saved three match points in a row. Bayor, if she can find herself in this moment, could find herself in the round of 32. Backhand does it! Natalia Bayor with a massive comeback to take out one of the top 10 seeds here.